My business partner with the tackle shop, Luke. We used to go out a lot, and he used to teach me how to fish carp properly. And so basically, him about 4 years ago, and he's still teaching me now. First fish was from Wilderness Fishery on the Horseshoe Lake. Probably a topping, a good whopping 9 pound off a nice little feeder rod. I think it cost me about 26 quid, but it was worth it. Not as often as I'd like to. These are probably the first 4 or 5 days I've done properly for maybe 2 or 3 months, and obviously with the bait and tackle shop, with it's been struggle to get out. So I'd say 2 or 3 months. Not really, because most of them don't understand what it is to go fishing. Most of them don't have the patience, to be honest. And I think with the golf, you can always go home after 4 hours, but I couldn't imagine fishing for less than 24 to be able to catch a good enough fish to be able to be satisfied. So I think that's mainly it. They get the fun, quick session of fun, and then off they go home. But to me, it's more about getting away from family than it is doing anything else. Shouldn't really say that. Luke. all my fish have been caught in his company and everything, so I take a lot of advice from him. He knows a lot more. He's been fishing a long time. Obviously, Keith Arthur opened our shop. So I speak to Keith and a few of us. So hopefully, getting more experience, you meet more people, learn more things. But I'm just open to learning everything. And obviously, I can't fish, but I'd love to do a bit of every kind of fishing that I could. But no one in particular, just everyone that's willing to give advice. Because we love fishing so much, me and Luke, we go together, and it was funny because we'll be sat on a bank and saying, oh, we need this, we need to go buy this, and we'd be going to a bait shop and thinking, well, if we had his own, we wouldn't need to. And then only a few weeks ago, when I went fishing the last month or so, Luke rang me and said, oh, do you need any bait to go fishing? I said, no, I just bought some. He said, you own a fishing tackle shop, you know, that we have bait. So, but it's not about that. It's not about getting free things. It's about good quality prices for good quality equipment, and that's what we're trying to do. And I mean, we're not massive by any means, but we try and do it the right way. And if somebody came in and asked for advice, we wouldn't turn them away because they're not buying anything. So it's all about sticking together as anglers, and we all want everyone to catch, and it's nice if they can do it off our tackle or bait. Well, we've just started an online eBay account. You can connect to it through our website, which is going really well. Obviously, just little bits from now on, and build it up slowly, because there's a lot of people that are going out of business now by just buying too much in and not being able to sell it, especially with the recession recently. And that's why we're trying to do it as cheap as we can without killing ourselves, and hopefully we can get a few people on the bank again. And we hopefully want to get a lot more children fishing, and my children fish now and enjoy it, so that's one of our aims as well. Actually, this week, I think we've got 12 fish between us, and I think everyone's been £28. we was up at 3 o'clock this morning, and Luke went, "Oh, it's a nice fish, that." And he went, "What do you think it is?" I said, £28. And it was 28, 2 or 4. It was unreal night. Some good things. I seen good old James getting in to get my fish. He could have picked it up out the side, and he was trying to get the rig off the tree. He could have picked the fish up and caught it from it. That was quite funny, and tried to get out there. And now this week's been pretty funny, good company, and good fishing, so on our side, on the gravel side. But no, it's probably been a very funny week this week. I'd love to go marlin fishing or something like that, but to me, I'm a carp man. I just can't get away from it. And if there's a big carp to be caught, I'll try it out. And first time in France, I'll be definitely back as soon as possible. And if you're listening, Katie, I'll see you next Friday rather than this Friday. For it not to rain. To me, even if I blank and I learn something, it's a good day all round. And we've come out here, caught 12 fish in just over 48 hours. I think between us we've caught £350 worth of carp. So you can't ask for much more. And this place is going to be a stunning place, which it is now. But when it goes on and the fish go to a size, I mean, it goes up to £60 now. If that comes out now, then in a year's time, what could it be? 68, pushing 70. So I think this place, I'll be definitely going back here next year. Luke, mate, I'm plugging you a lot here, Luke, but to be fair, you kind of stick to your own people, and Luke and I get on really well. We fish for each other. Like, he'll be rigging up and I'll be baiting up. That's why I can't move my arm from my knee right now, because the throwing stick's been punishing over the last few days. But no, he's a good angler and he's a good teacher, and if you listen to him, you usually catch a fish, and that's what it's all about. Just recently, last week, I took the little ones to the horseshoe and on Willinghurst, and we caught a few 10, 12 pounders. The littlest girl caught them, so that interests me. I like different styles of fishing, feeder fishing. But to me, if I had the choice of a 24, 48 hour session, I'd go for a bigger fish. It's always about getting better and learning more techniques. And if you blank, every fisherman's blanked, and if they aren't, they're a liar. I mean, I've only really gone for the boilie approach, like I am doing here. I'd love to get one off the top on a nice warm day, but that'll come with a fly rod, hopefully, and go down Willinghurst and try that out, get better at it. I wouldn't like to come to a place like this and try it without, for the first time, because it's a tough lake. If you get into a big fish, they can plod along. But I think the boilie approach, because I'm a lot more up to speed on that, and the rigs that I can do myself, and what I'm comfortable on catching fish with. Probably the ones that we're using this today, the boilies, the ice red, the bait, the ice red from Carp Company. We've had the fish feeding really well on them, up to 36 pounds. So in 48 hours, we've gone through a lot of that, and they've really got on it. So it's good quality bait and we've caught a lot of fish on it, so I have to say that one. Luke, my bivvy and a fish. Yeah, I would say a frying stick, but I can't move my right arm, so I'm not going to say a frying stick. I won't mind a bait boat, but no, I'd say them three things. This week, nice little grass carp, 36.6. First fish, actually. And then from then on, I was fairly happy to sit here and watch everybody else catch, but the people in the next swim were pretty useless, so... We thought we'd catch for them, and we've got some good fish out, and I bet you there's a competition that you can't guess what the rest of the fish weighed. 28 pound, every single one of them. And I won't mind having a few more 28 pounds, but if we can beat that, if not, then we'll probably wade out and catch it with his hands. Well, you get the old cliche of a showman picture of a caught fish, the only thing you've caught this year. So that's nice. But no, it's just getting on a bank and with your friends and having a laugh and catching fish. You can't tell people how relaxing it is and the adrenaline rush when your line goes in the middle of the night. You might fall in water first, but as long as you get the fish in, you've got to have a bit of patience, a bit of... And obviously you've got to like fishing and be prepared to learn, because it's not an easy sport to just go and do. But there's people out there, like we're trying to do at our tackle shop, that'll teach you. You stand on the bank for a couple of hours, your kids or yourself catch a few fish, it's the old cliche again, but you get hooked, you're away, and that's what I did 4 or 5 years ago, and not looked back since. Well, me. It's got to be a £40 common today, because if I was at Wembley anytime soon, it'd be in the playoffs. So definitely £40 common. I spoke to Hugo Rodriguez about going to Colombia, taking me there, and he said, yeah, I'll look after you. And I'm not sure if he's worried about the fish or Colombia, but Hugo said he'd look after me and he'll take me on a guide. And to be honest, I'd like to go everywhere around the world and just fish and see what you can catch and see how many times I can break my line off in a tree and send James in to go get it for me. He wouldn't mind going in with piranhas to get it, I don't think.